Broadcasting live from the Vile Stadium in San Francisco, home of the 40 Nightmares. You know why this team is named that? Because their fans are known to wake up in a cold sweat screaming at the top of their lungs. I don't blame them.
Don't poke fun at their city, Grim. Plenty of great places to eat if you like vegan.
Hey, I love to eat vegans, but they all look wine when you're cooking them.
The teams are juiced up and ready for blood as they take the field for NFL action. The New Orleans Zombies battle the San Francisco 40 Nightmares. Welcome to NFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. The paddy wagons in the parking lots are full, the familiar scent of bodily fluids in the air, and the men's room is both flooding and on fire. And that means NFL Game Day is on the air. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzer along with Bricks and Bricks Jr.
Man, last week some mutant let out a lava blast in one of the stalls in the men's room. Place went up like an oil rig. Flames and explosions, water shooting out of where the toilets were. I electrocuted myself using the electric hair dryer. I wish they had paper towels at least as an option.
And it's first and 10. Second down and long. They'll be washing bloody footprints off the defense's jerseys after a run like that. Third down and 3.
Drop a lot of balls in the path.
With the vicious kill.
Did you know late hits are one of the leading causes of death for mutants over 25?
I didn't know that.
Yeah, right below attending bachelor parties and owning a Sam Schlong Galaxy phone.
Wasn't he, Bricks? Wonder what made him so mad.
Yeah, it was probably all the diarrhea.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort, and he just got so mad and cursed anyone who...
The defense better look out. The offense called the Beast Boost. Defense was there, but he still picked up a yard somehow. Second down and 9. Field goals over 40 yards are difficult. He's going to really have to boom this one. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make him pay. Ha ha! first and 10. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. First down and a mile.
Hot one, hot two, hot eight.
That's a catch for a 4-yard gain. Second down and a mile.
Hot one,
eight. He broke free. He just put that guy out of his misery and says, who's next? Now the offense is getting kills. This is really a violent game, guys. And it's first and 10. To dig out a yard on that one.
Not my yard. Got too much buried in, you know, the usual money, bodies, coffee cans filled with, well, you know, mostly coffee. Tastes better, like Eskimos burying salmon heads, kimchi. I mean, anything really tastes good.
Second down and 9.
Boat all grim?
Nope.
And whoever said never hit a man when he's down is just plain lazy. Nice extra effort there.
And it's first and 10.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
Second down and 10. Quarterback passes for a touchdown. Now, this reminds me of a lap dance I had by a skeleton once.
Oh, yeah, after the mayhem ball at that club 6 feet under? Yeah, my wife could smell the bone marrow on me when I got home. Big trouble.
Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters then.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And he pumps his way out of that tackle. And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot eight.
Boom! And like the Titanic, his ship just went down.
Hey, I almost got that mutant bingo. All I need is 77 to bite it.
First and 10. First down. And the offense has only 2 running backs left, and the defense is licking their lips.
I think they want to hit those last 2 runners for this outfit.
And it's first and 10. Picks up 2 yards on the pass.
And this guy's 6 feet tall. He could just have fallen over and gotten 2 yards.
And that'll be 2nd and 8 to go.
You know, this berserk dirty trick ain't fair to the QB.
Oh, mama! He just knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
6. Interception, and that's how you stop an offense. Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grim. You're right. What did we get out of it?
And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
Love the sound of bump.
Oh, that was totally uncalled for. And that's why we love the NFL. Second down and 9.
Hot one, hot two.
Third down in. The punter is warming up. And I've had it. I'm running out of excuses for this. Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe. And if you don't understand why refs are hated even more than kickers, well, there's your answer, Bricks. That's the end of quarter one. Well, the good news is there's still time to make it a game.
And there's still time to get a beer.
Third down and 8. The defense had enough with this ref and jumps off sides to kill him. It's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot
eight. Oh, nice hit. Second down and a lock.
Hot one, eight.
And that's a great 9-yard completion there.
Hey, it ain't great if you don't score or move the chains.
Third down and 3. And he reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive alive. First and 2.
Hot one, hot two, hot eight.
Second down and 7.
Hot one, hot two. Eight.
And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done.
See that move, baby? I'm the greatest. No, you didn't see it.
They're going for 2 points. 2-point plays are high risk, high reward, and it just didn't pay off.
And now they're both screwed. And stupid.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
For a first down. And it's first and 10. Oh. racks up 9 yards on that catch. And that'll bring up 2nd and 1. And that's another pick. Man, oh man, the deep. Oh, that's a vicious hit. And the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of brown mutiny.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. And it's 1st and 10.
Hot 1, hot 2.
The defense goes a sticky, and that's a sack.
Speaking of sacks, has anybody seen my powder? I'm itching like crazy over here.
Second down in a very lot.
Hot 1, hot 2.
Couldn't get there.
Yeah, neither could his mother.
Third down and, well, good luck. Nice run there for 8 yards. And they'll line up for the punt here. And he got it off. That's a decent punt. He's got the ball now. Let's see what he does.
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
And it's 1st and 10.
Ah, another interception. Geez, you give this guy a
big hit. Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I'll bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Ah, let's see. About a quarter after 3, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
And it's 1st and 10. Football, he gets away in a hurry. Just follow the bloody footprints to the new line. That's a first down. The ref calls a penalty. You know, the NFL has eliminated almost every penalty in the rule book, and yet it still feels like there's way too many penalties.
Stupid jerks. You guys suck.
The offense lost another running back and only two remain on their roster. When a team loses all their running backs, they lose their ability to run the ball.
Yeah, like if I rip out your tongue, you won't be able to speak. Tell us something we don't know, genius.
First down and 1.
Hot 1, hot 2, hot.
And he runs it in for the touchdown. Hey, Bricks, they're going for 2 here. The QB threats the needle for 2 points. You know, if you go frame by frame, you can see the cover of my son's death metal album.
Yeah, baby. Throw up the horns.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. He sits up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. And it's 1st and 10. Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? And that'll bring up 2nd and 1. necessary. I gotta see that one again.
It was also freaking awesome. I hope they had raincoats in the front row because that was splattering everywhere.
And it's first and ten. Well, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Get the ball, asshole. Hey, asshole, up here. Talking to you.
Somewhere, but he gets stumped after three.
They usually stop me after three, too. You know, the all-you-can-eat buffets? They're not as literal as you think.
The offense is losing quarterbacks faster than teams lose their minds at spring break. They're down to their last QB before they have to forfeit. And that'll bring up third down and seven. Somehow and hold on for the first down.
This guy has a nice set of hands, Grim. It's the third set of hands he's had so long today. Looks like it's a good fit.
And they quickly call a timeout to stop the clock. And it's first and ten.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not yawn.
They stopped the clock, but they only have one timeout left.
That's okay, Grim. They can have nine.
That's nice, Bricks. But our timeouts are for our sponsors, and we need money more than they do. That's a four-yard gain. And that's the last timeout. They can't stop the clock anymore.
Can any of us really stop the clock, Grim? I mean, when it comes right down to it, are we not all united by the constant reminder of our own mortality? Of death's constant, relentless advance? If only it was as easy as...
The defender says, I don't think so. I'd be impressed if he splits the uprights from this far away, Bricks.
If he doesn't, they're gonna split his skull wide open.
Kick is good. They need a good return here to set up the offense. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he named his clothing company Lukewarm Threads. Their marketing team hates it.
First and ten. And a hard run there picks up the first down. Under 2 minutes of timeout means the QB is playing beat the clock, and he better win. And it's first and ten. He's got his beast boost working. The player just transformed into a violent form of pure badass. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path. The offense is down to their last running back. When he bites the dust, they can only pass. That's right, but now the defense can focus on killing the receivers. And it's first and ten. Second down and more than the QB would like. It's a close battle as the quarter ends. Halftime is brought to you by those caring folks at Monsanto Industries. They make the world a better place by making the government tell you it is. It's anyone's game as the third quarter begins. Both teams have taken their performance-enhancing drugs, and everyone is ready to rock and roll. The teams line up for the second half kickoff. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and 10. And that was a bone crusher right there, folks. Mama, just call him Cap'n Crunch. Another one bites the dust. The offense has no running backs left, so this becomes a passing-only offense.
They can still run it with their QB, right, Grim?
Sure, they can run their QB into the defense that's feasting on runners. Sounds like a good plan, moron.
Hey, watch it!
And it's first and 10. And he's off to the races. The 30. The 20. And the quarterback drills one in for the first down. And it's first and 10. And the defense gets another pick. Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grim. You're right.
And it's first and 10.
First down! This guy just...
Boom, dead and down. Nothing more to say about this guy except maybe a eulogy.
He was a violent alcoholic, a terrible father, and he did some nasty things to dogs. But, he was a great ball player. That's really what counts at the end of the day, right?
And it's first and 10. Look out, that's an all-out attack on the...
It's not how many times you fall, it's how you get back up.
Yeah, in this particular case, I'm thinking defibrillators and 100 cc's of adrenaline.
Yeah, they both wouldn't hurt either.
Did somebody say cocaine?
40 Nightmares win by forfeit. Heard the expression, left it all on the field? Well, they left the other team's bodies on the field. There's not much left of the opposition, and the fans are loving it. There was only one way this game was going to end, and that was in a forfeit.
That's not quite true, Grim. An alien spacecraft could have crashed into the stadium and ended the game, or how about it?
How about if you shut the hell up right now and we go down to the field and listen to what the MVP has to say? Once again, the folks at Evil SN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's final game stats are brought to you by the MicroHard Corporation. They get it right every...